Well, did you know that aging is actually not inevitable? And our next guest says there are ways to slow the aging process.
Yes, and we are super excited to hear about this. Celebrity physician Dr. Robert Huizenga is joining us, and we're talking about reversing aging. Is that even possible?
Yeah, you know, now we have multiple ways to slow down aging, speed up aging even, and sometimes reverse it. So it's malleable.
Okay, great. Well, let's get started. Well, let's start with genes. Genes are really important, I think.
Right. Everybody thinks, oh, it's all genetically determined. Yeah. Forget it. 20% is genetically determined. You got 80% in your control that you can take care of with healthy lifestyle.
All right. What, so what exactly causes aging? And you say that we'll age faster if we live too comfortable?
Well, aging is damage of your body that you don't repair. And we've got these secret survival systems in our cells that if you just tweak them, if you exercise, if you're hungry, if you go in a cold plunge, it'll tweak the system and repair better. That slows down your aging.
You're saying to embrace hunger. That is no fun.
Hunger is a good feeling.
Really?
When you're hungry, you feel yourself getting younger.
Okay.
You've got to learn to love it.
And what's that philosophy? Like, literally, I have a friend who says, I've become friends with my hunger pains, right? Because he's trying to lose weight. But what is that doing to the body?
Well, that is tweaking these adversity genes, these adversity mimetics to repair your DNA, to refold your torn proteins, and that keeps you young.
Okay.
All right, so basically you're saying this puts your body in a state of adversity. But going back to that other thing, I thought, you know, there's also the thing, if you eat every couple of hours, it speeds your metabolism.
That was so backward. That's going the exact opposite way. No one had ever tested that out. That deal, have your kids eat every 2 hours.
Yeah.
Let the kids be hungry, because when they gain fat, when they eat too much, they develop quicker and they age quicker.
Okay, and then what's this whole pile? Because this pile makes me happy, and you're saying, nah.
Not so much. We have
really?
To go for high fiber. We have to go for healthy protein. This is simple carbohydrate in the main, and we've got to avoid that if we can. There's some tricks if we do eat it, but try to avoid
it. Okay, what's the trick? Because I'm taking this one right here.
Well, the trick is, first of all, when you open it, you'll smell it, and then you're gone. That's
all right.
So the trick is, if you eat simple carbs, wash it down with about a half a liter of water, because it's not how much sugar you eat, it's the concentration of sugar in your body. And if you dilute it with water, you'll have less harmful effect.
Okay,
so this is not necessarily good. What about this middle bowl? Traditionally, that would have to be right on.
Fruit is a great thing. It's got a lot of phytochemicals. It's very healthy. The problem is the body can only handle so much. So one fruit a meal is your max. If you have more than that, sometimes the way the body metabolizes fructose, it goes to fat. And we want to avoid that, obviously.
And then similar times, you're saying that we should eat on a regular basis.
Yeah, circadian rhythm is huge. We have to wake up at the same time, eat at the same time, work out at the same time, go to bed at the same time, because one of the signs of aging is a bad clock. And you want to do everything you can do to encourage that 24-hour cycle.
Just, this is not on the list, but how important is sleep?
Sleep is amazingly important, and if you don't get enough sleep, you're going to have an increased risk of Alzheimer's, you're going to have an increased risk of anxiety and depression, and you're not going to have the oomph to go out and exercise and do all the other healthy things I'd like you
and
to
we
do.
We need the oomph.
All right, real quick, if too much sugar, too much salt, if you indulge, how do you get back on track?
Well, I think to get back on track, it's just one little bit of sugar, it's one little bit of salt. You can have the water afterwards, you can try to eat sugar and desserts after you have a full meal, so it's absorbed slower, but you got to get back on track. One bad thing doesn't destroy your body.
And then what about this event that you have?
Well, I'm really, really excited about it. We've been looking forward to it. We're going to talk about a lot of different tips. I think I have 100 different tips to try to biohack your way into 100. And we'd like to talk about some of the research I've been doing for the last 3 years that I think is really important about other tricks to hook into those adversity mimetic genes.
And this is at the Saban Theatre in Beverly Hills?
Correct, yeah.
Okay, great. Online. Sounds good. Well, I know you have a lot. You've been doing the research specifically for the last 3 years.
Correct.
That's great.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, if you'd like to attend Dr. Robert Huizenga's upcoming event, Age Reversal, Science Fiction or Factual Science, at the Saban Theatre in Beverly Hills tomorrow, go to the website you see right there on your screen. Doctor,
all right.
Good to see you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, great
Appreciate
to see
it.
You too. Thank you.